And I'm not gay.
No.
Rumors. Vicious rumors. It's warm.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, guys.
How's everyone doing? We're getting back to music here.
One, two, three.
This is the official boob show. Yes, it is. We have to show off. You have to stand up today. Are you ready? We have to show them off at the same time. We have to. Excellent.
Where's the dollars? Where's the dollars?
I know. Give him a dollar. This is the first time you've seen her face. That's because you're not usually here, Jamie. Thanks for staying up, darling. All right, you have to stand up. We have to show off our shirts. Even though everybody has probably shown them off today. Stand up.
Bill, I am
Spanky,
ready.
You're not listening to me.
No.
Stand up.
Hey, how come you have a cute little hat? I need a hat.
Sorry. Stand up. We have to show.
You said.
Look what we got. Woo.
I can't get any closer to my phone.
Very nice. Nice lanyard, too.
There.
Oh, Chaos Kitten is throwing dollars at us. Awesome. Sending me messages on Skype. Stop it. I can't see Skype.
That's the only problem with the shirt. They're cut.
Oh, it's not too bad to me. Happy be here. Thank you, PMer. I tried to fix it. And our shirts have our names on the back, too, but I don't know if I can get it in the screen properly, so I'm not gonna...
Okay, Chaos, I am so glad you're not the only one that said it. I was putting it on going...
Oh, you're welcome, Faith DM.
Here, hang on. Yeah, they were a little small. They're...
Can you guys see my name? Spanky, can you see my name?
Sure. Woo, yes.
Oh, awesome, PMer. Oh, for the love of God, already? Are you in the room only once today? Oh, you made it only one time. Good for you.
I can do it too if I want to. I figured out what it was. I don't know why. But if I popped out, Cat, it would keep me logged in as Spank here, but when I would pop it out, it would log in as
Cat. Oh, that's weird.
So I just don't pop it out anymore.
Yeah, I think that is a record. Eamon comes in and says, let's start the anal bleaching and let the whole thing go to shit. Really? We've been on for 8-ish minutes. We haven't even been talking for that long.
He was in here just a little bit ago, Misty. Was even doing a little dance.
Well, that was when I had the... This picture, guys, I want to put this back up real quick so you can see it. That's not a picture. Keep calm and vape on with Spank and Amy. Spanky's son made that for us. If you were going to DIY a juice, I would call it Amy's sparkly hat. What would it taste like?
Sparky. It needs to have some kind of fizzy to it.
Yeah, it's got to have like a champagne taste in there if you're going to put sparkly in the name, I think.
All his juices are awesome.
Oh, yeah. Misty wants to talk to Matt about creating a juice flavor.
What kind of juice? Oh.
By the way, I wanted to talk about... Dang it, wrong hand. This right here, feel your boobies. I know I've been talking about it. My friend Carrie had her surgery today. Came out of surgery just fine. Is in her room recovering, so...
Oh, that's good to hear. I don't know if you guys... I don't know... Did you hear about this, Amy? There's, the Alabama vape... Alabama vape.
Your sound is terrible today.
I want to put my mic closer. Is that better?
Yes.
Okay, so the Alabama vape team is putting together a meet. And I guess he kind of put out a challenge to the vendors. And, like, the juice flavor is apple pie. And everybody's supposed to do their version of an apple pie and send it in, and they're going to do kind of a contest and see who does that.
Timo, please don't post it on YouTube, okay? If you want to test your stuff, that's fine, but I'll have to talk with you about that before we can post anything anywhere. That's all. Jimmy, what are you doing?
Chocolate-covered pretzel. You're going to have to work on that one. That's actually very interesting. When he comes in here, I'll ask him. I'm sure he can get some kind of idea.
Yeah. Yeah, she asked me the other night, and I said, you know what? You need to remember that, because I'm never going to remember by Friday.
Apple pie is really good, and I don't like bakery vapes, especially pies and danishes in a vape. And we were working on it tonight, and it's actually really, really good. And for me to say that,
I hope your doctor's checking for you, kitten. Because my friend went from a clear mammogram last April to a tumor the size of a tennis ball this May. So feel your boobies, ladies, or, you know, have someone who knows what they're looking for. I put my list on shuffle so nobody knows what's coming.
Not even you. That's a whole nother subject.
Yes.
And I think I would like to vape chocolate covered cupcakes. But
yes, men can get breast cancer as well. It's less common, but.
Okay.
Say that again.
The lighting in here is different.
Yeah, your lighting is different today. So did you guys all see this article of the woman who had the Ego Style battery explode out of the outlet in her house? It went around Facebook a little bit. Billy, can you link that in the room, please? So she had an Ego Style battery. I don't know if it was an official Ego or whatever, but I saw it in the video, and there's a video on there you guys can go watch. It's hard for me to get screen regions up on this right now. But she said that the people who sold it to her told her she could use any charger she wanted. So she showed the charger she was using, and it was one of those little bitty, like, USB ones that come with, like, little rechargeable 510 kits. You know, the Sigalite kits that have the little bitty USB charger? She was using that with an Ego battery. And it shot out of her wall and set her carpet on fire. But in this article, she's saying that it made three big fires in her living room. Now, this is still bad. Don't get me wrong. It is bad. But I saw the damage it did to her carpet. There is no fucking way that this was three big fires. Host on another channel, his name is Blacksmith Pro, he hosts on Vape TV. He said he's seen more damage that has happened to carpet from cat vomit than what happened with this to this lady. Now, it's still bad, but this is proof that you should not use the wrong charger. You get a particular charger with your device because that is what you are supposed to use with it. Don't use. What I'm guessing they told her was she probably got an Ego charger without a wall adapter. They probably told her she could use any wall adapter that a USB fit in. But I don't know. I don't know where she bought it. They didn't say. So she used the wrong kind of charger and it exploded. And I'm done complaining about that. I have been to Vape Bash and I went to Vape Fest last year and Vape Bash this year, Chili. Zeb got a webcam.
Yay, Zeb!
Exactly.
Now he's
got to
do the dance.
Yep. Now he's got to do the dance. Oh no, we're skipping this song. Farewell, Backstreet Boys. Well, sort of. Darth. Yes, what's left of the battery does look like a cat accident in the corner. Still not taking a selfie of your ass? That's not a problem. Someday when you're on cam, you'll get up and walk away without forgetting to turn it off, and I'll be there to take a screenshot.
And share.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, you shouldn't charge on your computer either.
Just in case I disappear, there is a huge rainstorm going on right now. Thunder, it's lightning. I don't know if you saw me jump.
You can use, Timo, you can use any wall adapter. You can use a wall adapter from like an iPhone or a cell phone that takes a USB. But what this lady did, instead of using the corded one, that has a little Ego attachment on the end. She was using one that just looked like a little tiny USB thing that's plugged in. Good night. Zeb. Yes, be safe, girl. In that weather. Misty got lots of fave mail. Yeah, you can
Zeb,
use the,
where
any...
do you think you're going? Zeb thinks you're taking off.
Well, you know, if he doesn't want to be here, that's fine.
Just tie him down.
He wishes. But no, the USB cord that comes with an Ego battery, you can plug those into any wall adapter. I do not recommend charging them in your computer. You can rack the USB. She was using... Hold on, I will go get something that I have that looks like it. Give me 1 second. It's hard for me to explain. Handle things for a minute, thank you.
Wait, there was another one. I saw the lightning. Let's hear from you. Did you hear that? I've used mine in the car, I will admit. So, okay, I don't know. Some of you guys were here last week when I showed this thing that Matt has. I don't know if he has the charger here. Let me see. How's the battery? Find the charger. Oh, it's right here.
Okay.
This thing right here. So it's a regular, it looks just like a regular Ego battery. See?
Oh, you were showing this off last week. I love that one.
Yeah. And it just snaps right in. I mean, you can't even put it in the wrong way. It's magnetized. It's like trying to magnets together that won't go in.
So you can't hook it up the wrong way. That's nice.
You can't hook it up the wrong way. You can't mistake it with something else. Nice the fact that
Pooh Boo, I would not recommend charging on your computer. You could wreck that USB port really easily. So, on an Ego, you get one of these. You get the cord. It's got your two little ends, right? Ego-style battery. Usually you get this with the USB end. You can use any wall adapter with this. Okay, but what she was using, I have here in this, what was this? The green smoke kit that I got. She was using one of these, which are not for Ego batteries.
Yeah.
She was using one of these plugged into a wall adapter, which is the wrong charger. PM'er, kinda.
Yardbird's back. Yay. Call. Vicky, I even brought, look at what I found for Yardbird. Flappers. That way Yardbird can come and sit over here on my step. Will you
forgive and I won't forget. Yes, you may be blunt. Know what we've seen. Yes, Mumford and Sons are very popular here.
They were here in Taos when Dibbo was here, did they?
Yeah, because you guys, they went to the concert. They're saying you're very echoey. That's my fault, because my headset is crap.
Echoey is better than airplane, which is what we have lately. And I'm not in an airplane anymore. That's a good thing.
It's just been a day, PM'er, but thank you. Exactly. I completely agree. Although, I think she misunderstood what her vendor told her. Now, I don't know if her vendor did say, you can use any charger you want. What I'm thinking is they gave her a cord like this, you know, with the the ego end and your USB end, and said she could use any adapter for this cord, and she took that to mean
use anything you have.
Jamie, can you message that to me on Facebook so I can remember to look them up, because I can't do it right now. Too bad it wasn't in her lap. But yeah, she had the right cord and she chose to use something else, and I don't know why, and that was really fucking stupid. Uh-oh. I know that giggle. Exactly. Survival of the fittest at its finest. The Darwin Awards are around for a reason. Yes. Hi, Sharon.
Sharon.
Hey, Sharon. Exactly. Take off all the warning.
Well, I hope that doesn't happen. That would make me really sad. But I... No offense, but I agree. Yeah, here's your sign. Chili, you're right. She shouldn't have been able to connect the wrong charger to the wrong battery, but... Yeah, my hair dryer has a warning. I don't use it anymore because my hair's so short. But my hair dryer has a warning that says, do not use while showering.
Okay, I want to know why there was a need to put a warning not to use a curling iron internally.
Because you know...
Who is the one that tried to do that?
That's why all the warnings are on everything. Jeff Foxworthy does a thing about this, and he said... Why would you even need to tell us that? Who would do that? And then he went, because somebody did it. Like that lady who spilled hot coffee in her lap at McDonald's and got like $1 million. That's why all of the lids have to say, caution, contents may be hot. Really? I ordered coffee and it might be hot?
It has pictures.
What?
Turn it into a maze. You guys have to find your way in and out.
Yeah, exactly. Stupid people. Oh, Jamie, I agree. I absolutely agree. Oh, I spilled hot coffee in my lap and it burned me. I'm going to sue McDonald's. How is it McDonald's' fault that you had too much shit in your fucking cup holders and couldn't put your coffee where it belonged?
Hey, Missy!
Hi, Missy! Yeah, what happened with that donkey, right? Right.
How close are you to the border of Mexico, Mrs. T?
Yeah. Yeah, are you sure it doesn't say don't bathe the burro in the bathtub? We used to have a restaurant here. I don't know if it was a national restaurant called Chi-Chi's. First of all, I'm pretty sure you know what Chi-Chi's are. But they had like a... It's almost like a chimichanga kind of meal, but they called it the burro. And my friend Cindy Alvarez was there, and she goes, a burro, I'm not eating that for dinner. Like, no.
Oh, good night, Blackie. I have not done a damn thing this week, real. I'm Corey. I come to eat. That's my... I go work. I come to eat. And they go home. That's it.
I loved Chi-Chi's when you told them it was someone's birthday. They made them stand on a chair and wear a giant sombrero and sing happy birthday. You can complain as much as you want. You're welcome to complain. Okay. okay, it, yes, it was too hot, but again, it's not McDonald's fault that she didn't clean her car out and she couldn't put it in the damn cup holder where it belonged.
Mmm, fried ice cream. We have a place here that does fried ice cream.
Yes, the fried ice cream was the greatest part about going.
When you come, Amy, we'll go to the quad.
Oh, yay.
They have fried ice cream. I'm thinking, Amy, that we might want to do the bead giveaways first, because they're talking that there might be a power outage.
Okay, well, let's, you know what? Let's just do two in a row then, right now, and get them out of the way. We'll switch this to the bees. Everybody pay attention for just a half a second. Watch your screen. Are you ready? I hope you all got a chance to see that. Shh. Okay, let's see. How many do we have? We have 39. Wow, 39. Thanks, guys.
Okay, well, this gift certificate is good for $10.98 at www.bliquid.com, which will cover one 15-ml bottle of your choice, which includes shipping, so that the free, clicky, free, silk, nothing out of your pocket bottle of juice.
You can get a free 15-ml bottle of juice, or you can use it for $10.98 off of something else. If you'd like to order something else or more stuff, you'll get $10.98 off.
I don't think he has any equipment stuff.
But I mean, like, if you wanted to order, you know, three bottles of juice, then one of them's free, or...
Yeah, definitely.
We need a Link Ninja. Billy, are you around, dear? Can you put Bee's link in for me, please, honey?
Timo wants to pause this later.
Yeah, so he can look at that picture again. I didn't see anything. I don't know what
I
you guys are
nothing.
Talking about.
Yeah, minion number 9 is definitely good. Zombie is always the flavored.
Thanks, guys, ladies. Since Billy's ignoring me. What does minion number 9 taste like?
It's a watermelon and candy flavor. I know what the candy is, but I'm not going to say.
That's fine. You can say a candy and watermelon.
I'll tell you what it is later.
Okay, but don't give away all his secrets to, you know, the whole world or anything.
Of course.
So that's descriptive enough. Yeah, real. I'm curious if the buffalo enjoyed it. Why would it be illegal? All right, get your numbers in. I'm going to put in the stop because we need to do both of our bees giveaway just in case the power goes out. Vape DM, I know. It was the only frivolous example I could come up with, and it wasn't completely frivolous, but you still shouldn't be holding a hot liquid between your legs. All right, let's see. We have 5. I hope you guys can see that. I didn't check my screen really well before I got on here. I see a 2.
Oh, the minion number 9 does not need teeping. It's good right out of the...
I see a 2, right, and I see an 8. I think 2 and 8, 3 away, both of them are going to have... You see anything closer than 2? Oh, 4. Sharon with a 4. Sharon piffed to Sweetie.
Sharon 4?
Yeah.
Yep, that's it.
All right, so she piffed to Sweetie, so congratulations, Sweetie. You are the big winner of a $10.98 gift code to Bee Liquid. Spanky will be getting in touch with you.
I'm looking for her name on the chatters. Hold on. Ooh, what did you think of the squirrel, Misty?
Stylin' Puffer. Nice to see you, darling.
Hey, Stylin'. Sweetie, she's cute!
I've been in hangouts with Sweetie before. Good night, Jamie.
Cutie!
Nice piff, Sharon. Thank you. Let me know when you're done and we will roll right into the next.
There you go, Sweetie.
And I have to say, we have 40 people in the room. That was not 40 numbers. All right, did you get it sent?
It is sent.
Okay. All right, putting in a start 1 through 40 again for B Liquid. I would like to point out the little yellow notepad in the corner that says, please. Oh, you don't have to send an email for this one, but please send the email with your selections to the email address provided ASAP. This ensures we can process your win in a timely fashion. You guys get your win right away from Bees. Please allow up to 4 weeks for delivery of your prize. Most of our vendors do not take that long, but be patient, people. It will show up. If it's been 4 weeks, you can contact me or you can contact Spanky. You can find us on Facebook or you can email one of us if you have our email address and let us know and we will make it right for you. I did have one who contacted me last week who hadn't gotten his Gen X vapors. Yes, include all of your address. Hadn't gotten his winnings. It had been 4 weeks. I contacted Gen X and he got it riffraff. You got it, what, 2 or 3 days later? I mean, they were super speedy and very apologetic, so. Get your numbers in, people. Stop, it's going.
Yeah, Visa is super fast.
Three from us. All right, we'll talk about that in a minute. Hold that thought, Vapory. Numbers, numbers. Stop going. PMer. Okay, hold on. All right, let's see who the winner of this one is. Six! Sharon's probably the closest one again.
With a four.
She's got a four. Let's see if anybody's got closer. Does anybody have a five? Oh, there's two. Okay. Sharon's four. Sharon, the big winner piffer today, it looks like.
Yep.
You're not seeing anybody closer, right?
Mm-hmm. No, I'm not seeing anything.
All right.
13-2. That's it.
There you go. Thank you, Sharon.
And she piffed to Sweetie. No, she piffed to Strawberry Fields.
So there
you
go.
Okay, Strawberry. Give me a second.
Kyle, you missed two, actually. We did two in a row. Just in case Spanky has some,
We might lose power.
Let me know. Kyle, what everybody wants to know is, did you voop? Or did you not take your vape with you?
Always take your vape with you.
Fran, you can say voop here all the time. Sharon makes the voop charm.
There you go, Strawberries. I just sent you a PM with your book, with your gift code.
All right, ready? We're going back on cam, sister.
And awesome tip, Sharon.
Yes, thank you, Sharon. Very sweet of you. Yeah, it's raining here today, too, but it's not, not thunderstorming, it's just raining.
Try to understand.
So yeah, aside from my my shirt, I did not get any vape mail this week. I actually didn't get very much mail, period, this week. The other day I went out and there was just a little postcard from the dentist telling my daughter happy birthday, because her birthday is this month. Ree, if it's been that long, contact the host. Because there's a chance that the email got lost or didn't get sent right, or, you know, something may have happened in the world of the interwebs. I am vaping black menthol, the last of my black menthol.
Zombie like usual.
We're kind of boring. Although this is the last of my black menthol, so next I will be vaping my Bat Dirt blend, because I haven't vaped that in a while and I kind of miss it.
Well, you're very welcome, Shane. Thanks, Pat. Seeing in a little bit.
Like my hat? Thank you. I got this hat in Vegas from a little cart in Old Vegas, if you've ever been there. I walked past it five or six times, or four or five times, something like that, and kept looking at it and kept picking it up, and my husband said, well, you just buy the damn hat so I don't have to keep walking past this cart. Like, okay, thank you. I was like, I don't know. Maybe I'll get, maybe I won't.
Vanilla ice. Ooh, where'd you get that from?
I am getting vanilla ice. I'm looking forward to that. Except they call it white ice now. And I forgot where it's from, because my... Yes, what happens in Vegas ends up on Vape on TV. Yeah, not everything I did in Vegas ended up on Vape on TV. I'm just saying. Ooh. Sweetie has news. Oh, and Laura, can you put in that article about Vape Dojo? There was a great article about Vape Dojo, too. Your bills are covered and you owe nothing. That is fabulous. Oh, Bird, I love your puns. They make me so happy.
I know, it's awesome.
But yeah, Laura, that's awesome. And if you want to post a link to the Vape Dojo article, because I can't do anything else on this screen right now. The screen is a mess.
What does it say? I don't think I caught it.
It's just all about how Brian and his wife, whose name I forget, started their shop, and how right away they had people coming in, and just basically how awesome Vape Dojo is. It was a little like local kind of write up about a business.
Nice.
Yes, Misty, since you got tons of vape mail, then you should be doing some reviews.
I'll be looking for the squirrel juice review.
So because I can't remember which kid is which at your house, how old is the son that made us our cool vape bond with Spank and Amy, huh?
15.
15, okay.
He found a nap. He was doing all kinds of stuff with the key palm stuff.
Good night, Chili.
So here I made you one. Awesome, Missy.
Yeah, I made sure I added that in. As soon as I was back at my computer after I saw that, I added it into my broadcast software so I could use it. There's an article, Vapor Reporter. It's a Vapor Reporter about Vape Dojo, if you guys would like to go and read it. One of our hosts on our channel, Andy, works for them. Yeah, Misty, I don't lie about my love for Selena Gomez's music. So how was work this week, Spanky?
Boring. God, it's drug.
What exactly do you do? I know where you work, but what do you do there? I'm curious, unless you don't want to talk about your work. But
I work in a nursing home. I work in the front office, in the business office. And I am the Walmart door greeter, basically, with lots of paperwork.
Oh, that's right. Vape DM won the Magoo on Andy's show. Andy gave away some good stuff from Vape Dojo last night. And I cannot announce who, but Spanky and I will probably soon be having at least one more sponsor, possibly two more. Not quite sure how we're going to arrange our screen to put that many vendor names up, but we'll work it out.
Figure it out, something. Because it always is slow, real.
Well, sometimes slow is okay, but...
It's a nursing home. Nothing fast there. Nothing.
That is awesome, PMer. I just need a job. That's what I need. At this point, I don't even really care where. I'm going to go apply at Dunkin' Donuts because they're hiring. I'll probably gain 100 pounds because of the Dunkin' Donuts and the Baskin Robbins together.
Dunkin' Donuts when they're coffee.
So. I hate coffee, so that's not a problem.
Oh, no.
Can you have the decaf?
I don't like the taste of coffee. FaceTM, I am in the Chicago suburbs. Yeah, right, Laura? I should. I don't think my husband would go for that. I think he's happy here in our Chicago area. Yeah, another job just to support your vaping habit. Yeah, sorry about the echo, guys.
You should, real. You should.
I don't know how to make the echo go away at all. Who is echoing, her voice or my voice? Or both?
Probably mine.
If you reload, the echo is better. Okay. I'll reload, guys. I'm sorry. I don't know why it's so echoey tonight. I have nothing set differently than usual.
Usually I'm in an airplane, it seems like. You could hear the airplane going and the taking off. Sounds like we're in a wind tunnel on my end.
I should, Laura, I should try to come visit for the grand opening. That would be cool.
No.
Yeah, the plane is bad. I'm really sorry about the echo, guys. We don't usually have an echo like this. I don't know why we do this time.
Yeah. We did move into a bigger office.
That should matter.
How did I see we? Matt moved his office to a bigger room.
I don't want to start switching stuff around. Thank you, PMer. I will consider that. All right. I am going to go and make myself a drink. So hold down the fort. I will put up a...
I'm going to grab me something.
Yep, I'll put up our Be Right Backs. Wait, what? Sauces and dirty sex? Huh.
Who's gonna provide the dirty sex?
Well, you know, somebody has to.
The dirty job!
Alright, we're back on cam, girl. Oh my god, this is great. I love that girl. I showered. I just didn't feel like doing my hair, so I put the hat on. My hair takes 5 minutes, and I didn't feel like doing my hair.
I didn't get a chance to straighten it before
that. Your hair looks beautiful, like always.
DMer, stop teasing.
I don't have any PMers tonight. I feel kind of lonely and left out. None that are sending me anything, you know, super exciting. There are PMers that are sending me nice things and good information. Thanks, fake DM. I agree. Okay, well, dude, seriously, it's almost 11 o'clock at night. Go to bed. You're not taking that cat in that room. Don't leave him in there overnight. Alright. No, Ree, I'm still not getting any.
The After Effects. Yes, that is the whole reason that I don't cut it off.
There's plenty to hold on my head.
Mine's already almost to my butt.
Yeah, mine was very long. And I have had enough. Yay, it's our song.
I can feel it right at the top of my SoundCloud. SoundCloud! Say SoundCloud, Amy! SoundCloud! SoundCloud, SoundCloud! Return to the back. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Get up, first shot, come strut walking, a little bit of humble. No, my hair was down to just past my bra strap, and then it just got short. I cut about 5 inches off, and then I cut a little bit more off, a little shorter, and now super short, and I'm done. I like it so short.
I like mine short too, but I mean, even if people didn't, so long as I do, that's all that matters. PM or yes, I can help with that. Oh yes, where's the dancing minion tonight?
When I decide to actually cut my hair, it will go locked. Yes. Oh, the dancing minion is at a music festival that's going on at the local brewery here.
Kyle, yes, there's some kind of echo weird thing going. Black menthol is a blackberry menthol with a little hit. My second head, I don't know, I didn't hear from her today. Black menthol, blackberry menthol with a hint of banana. Very tasty. Okay, Ree, I will write that down and I will speak with them about that, okay?
I've always had really long hair, and I don't think it's so short.
See, and for years I had a girl who cut my hair who said, oh, I would never cut your hair short. It wouldn't look nice on you. I went to another guy, and he was like, oh, no, if you wanted short hair, then, you know, she was like, oh, we'll cut your hair. That's not a problem. Let's give it a shot. Love it. I have to write this down for me. Ree, I will look into that for you, okay?
Good night, Misty. Have fun with your heavy.
Good night, Misty. There is another one, Laura, but I don't remember what it's called. See, I don't miss my long hair at all. I'm thrilled it's gone. My kids are having what they're calling a mini sleepover. They're both sleeping in one bedroom tonight. And there was a moth in there, and they took the cat in there to catch the moth.
I like watching Finchies and babies.
Oh. Did you drop something? Do you want me to take you off cam so you can get it?
Not bad.
We'll do another giveaway in a couple minutes. So.
I have a lot of hair, but it's... I don't know if they want all the gray in it anymore.
They don't care.
They don't care?
No.
How about dyeing?
You can dye your hair so long as you use hair color products that do not have peroxide.
No.
Which you don't, because if you use peroxide, it would turn your hair orange.
Yeah, no, my hair turns orange. It's even light now.
Yes, dude, man, my showers are way shorter, too, because I don't use conditioner anymore, because I don't need it, because my hair is, like, that long.
Oh, my gosh. I always have to buy one shampoo, two conditioners.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't last. Plus, I do a leave-in conditioner.
Yeah, my daughter does, too.
And some of that frizzy stuff, that stuff is awesome.
She does not use frizzies. She has nice waves in her hair. It doesn't frizz. Yet.
Thanks.
That's not too bad. Your hair looks pretty. Oh my, Yammer. Fran went Sinead style and it was not planned. I'm sorry to hear that. Right, lather, rinse, repeat. It ends when you run out.
Air conditioner.
PMer, I don't know. I really don't know about that at all. You would have to go with what Derp told you about that one.
Oh my god, if I let my hair air dry, I'd look like the Cowardly Lion. I would.
See, mine is very straight, so when I let mine air dry when it was long, didn't matter. Still straight.
I wish mine was straight normally. Mine has just enough wave in it to be annoying.
Faith DM is very literal with directions.
Yes.
Dude, man, that's so nice.
Let's go see the Weezard. A Weezard.
Yes, we can get a brain, a heart, some courage, and go home. Wait, I'm already home. Relax. I look like a fucking poodle. I like that.
See?
Mine is stick straight. Ridiculous straight.
It would look like Steve comes in and he has the afro, he's got the ginger jufro.
Oh my god. I don't think there are any ginger Jewish people. I guess there probably are. But not if both of their parents are Jewish. Just saying. Oh my god. That's hilarious.
It does take forever to dry.
Right, we're going to do another giveaway.
Like a lot of times, when I shower in the morning, if I put my hand way back in here, even in the evening, I can still feel it a little damp. But does she have a
Jufro? She's little. I don't think that she's big enough to have that yet. We have 34. We'll still do 1 through 40. This is for Gen X Vapors. It is for one 30 milliliter bottle of juice. Winner's choice of flavor. and either 6 or 18 milligram nicotine strength.
I was waiting for the snort. It didn't come.
Nope, you didn't get the snort from me. I held it together. Thank you, Billy. Start Gen X Vapor 1 through 40. Can't touch this. Yay!
Can't touch this. Or the Hanukkah song from Adam Sandler.
Yes, I love the Hanukkah song. Makes me say, oh my lord, thank you. I know all the words to Can't Touch This. And I used to, when I was a special ed aide, I had a one-on-one student that I used to take to PE class. And when they were playing their game or whatever, the teachers would play music. The teachers would play two songs that were popular and then play this. And then they'd play one more song that was popular at the time. And then they would play Vanilla Ice, and me and the teachers would all be walking around singing. The kids are looking at us like we have some kind of mental problem. Because we do.
Okay.
Like that. But you're too much, because this is the beat they can't touch. By the way, in 5 days, it will be the 1 year anniversary of VapeOn.tv. August 7th last year.
Happy birthday, VapeOn.
Was the very first day that we ever broadcasted, and it was really fun, and we had 7 hosts at the time. I have not counted. I don't know how many we have now, but way more than 7. Had the original 7.
Lost is the one that brought me over.
Yeah, and he just disappeared, man. The stop's going. Get your numbers in. 30 milliliters of juice from Gen X Vapor.
Lost left and I stayed.
And the picture that is up on my screen is on their website. I stole it. Because I don't have any pictures of like their place or anything like I did for our other two. But that's the front page of their website, Vape Deliciously. Yes. Can't touch this. PMer, yes. Okay, his name was Lost, actually, Bird, but I like it anyway. It would have been better if he used Lost. Alright, let's see who the winner is. 32. Right off the bat, I see Eric with a 31. Oh, Chaos Kitten, 32. Anybody else have a 32? Or is it all Chaos Kitten all day? Oh, Kyle and Chaos Kitten. It is a juice off for Kyle and Chaos Kitten only. I will put in a little start for you guys to do 1 through 10.
And doggone it, people like me. I still like him.
Good enough, I'm smart enough, and doggone it, people like me. 1 through 10, Kyle and Chaos Kitten. Five.
Was that Saturday Night Live or was it Mad TV?
No, that was Saturday Night Live.
Saturday Night?
Because I never really watched Mad TV. I couldn't get into Mad TV.
I loved Mad TV.
I don't know why. There was plenty that was funny. But I don't know if it was just not on at a convenient time. I don't know.
I think it was like Mad TV was from 10 to 11 and then Saturday Night Live was from 10:30 to 12, so you kind of.
And look at that, Kyle wins. It's a 1, Kyle. I'm going to send you my email address. To that email address, please put in the subject line "Gen X Vapor Winner," or "Gen X Vapor," or "Gen X" something, so I know who you are. In the email, please put your name, your full address, a flavor choice from Gen X Vapor, and whether you would like 6 or 18 milligram nicotine. Congratulations. Again, please allow 4 weeks for delivery. Send your email soon. I will probably send it out tomorrow. I don't usually send them after the show because I'm usually drunk and I forget. We least I don't lie.
Trial cup. Back in around Heather.
I know all the words to this one, too. Frankly, I know all the words to just about every song on my playlist. Little Michael Jackson. Going back on cam. Spanky, does the back of your shirt have your whole screen name, or does it just say Spanky? I forgot.
It is a Spanky.
I forgot what you got.
It is a Spanky.
James, you ignorant slut.
Name, it would have been really small.
That's true. If that's a long name, you're right. Jane, you ignorant slut. That is an old one. That's a long time ago, Saturday Night Live.
I kind of played with that one, too. I was debating.
I liked one morning. We don't have morning shows here. So frequently I go to the morning shows over at Quest. And one morning, Case and Jibba were on over there, and someone knocked on Case's door, and all of us at the same time put in the chat, "Look out, it's the land shark." Andy Graham.
Ooh, the 70s.
Fran, I remember the 70s, too. Don't feel sad, honey.
So do I.
70s weren't bad.
Okay, here's one. Do you remember there was a skit show, if on Friday night. I think it was called Friday.
No, I don't remember that one. Samurai Bakery. Samurai Bakery World.
Friday. I wonder if it was called Friday or Friday Night.
No, Friday. I don't remember that one.
It was the one that had Toots the Cat.
No, I don't remember that one at all.
You remember Toots the Cat?
Uh-uh. Vape GTO had a birthday yesterday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
I do not remember Fridays. I don't. With Larry David, no. No. Not even like, oh yeah, I remember, but I never watched it. I don't remember it.
Toots the cat, and he used to drive, and he was just...
What flavor is Fireball? Be Liquid Fireball. What is that?
Like hot cinnamon.
That's
good.
It's a cinnamon. I didn't know if it was cinnamon and or if it was just a cinnamon thing. Hey, Ring, can you pick another color, honey? I love John Belushi. He was awesome.
Look what I can do. Oh, God, that was Stuart from Mad TV. I loved him.
I liked In Living Color. SCTV was good too. Don't badmouth SCTV people.
Mad TV had some awesome like characters. There was definitely Stuart. He was awesome. And Lorraine. I used to love Lorraine, that old lady. And Bobby Lee was in there. Anytime Bobby Lee did anything, he was awesome. Antonia and Dot. She was funny. Oh, and Miss Swan!
Mrs. Swan. I remember her. She was funny. Yes, SCTV with the McKenzie brothers. We play their 12 Days of Christmas every Christmas.
You look like a man.
You look like a man. My doctor, when I was pregnant with my daughter, was a Japanese lady. She didn't sound exactly like Mrs. Swan, but every time she talked to me, like in my head, I was like, she wasn't exactly the same, but still. Like, she told me, because my son was large, and they didn't want my daughter to be late. They wanted me to go early, right? So just want you to go a little bit early. But every time I went there, it was hilarity with her accent. She goes, "You go home, you go for a walk, you have more sex." It's like this 55-year-old Japanese woman telling me to go home and have sex. It was hysterical. Yeah, and then when I first went there, because I had to tell her, you know, my labor and delivery story with my son and stuff, because she wasn't there. I had a new doctor. And I told her he was 9 pounds, 2 ounces, and she goes, oh, I hate to tell you this. Second baby, usually bigger. I'm like, yeah, I know. Thanks. Yes, yellow is better. Thank you, Ring. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, the McKenzie brothers. Yes, she did. She told me to take a walk. Oh, I did. I laughed my ass off. You go for a walk, you have more sex. I told her, write that down on a piece of paper so that my husband knew that I was told by my doctor.
I have a prescription here, honey.
Because he would tell me he was weirded out and that he couldn't separate mom from wife when I got largely pregnant like that. I said, how do you think I feel when we're in the middle of it and the baby moves? Like, this is much worse for me, dude.
He was cheering you on, honey.
The baby was in there like, yeah, go, mom, go.
Come on, snort.
Nope. Nope. Not gonna happen. Not happening. Yes, that was the weirdest part. I mean, you know, you had to make adjustments for positions and things like that, but that was definitely the weirdest part. The baby moves and you're like, that was distracting and odd. Real, nobody is large enough to actually poke the kid in the head. I'm just saying. Not possible.
He was either cheering you on or protesting, one of the two.
PMer, I'm happy to hear that. Good for you. Dent in their foreheads. I'm sorry, our show is so unentertaining. PMer, probably. But I promise nothing. Yeah, soft spots in their heads, that's why. And they're about that big around, I'm just saying.
Good night, Shane.
Good night, Shane. Thank you. Thanks for coming by. We have a lot of people here this week. It makes me happy. Either they've heard we have a great show or they're here to watch the train wreck. I'm not quite sure which. People are like, oh my god, you have to go to this show. Everything goes to shit in the first couple minutes because Riff Raff comes in.
Talking about anal bleaching.
And mentions anal bleaching right away. Good night, Fran. Thanks for coming by, darling. Danny Swahili. Excellent name. Hello. It's too late at night to have a serious content heavy show. Nobody wants that this late on a Friday night.
Night, Fran.
See you soon, Fran. And hey, Mitch, every time I see your name, all I think is, oh my god, it's almost November. Oh, Riff Raff, absolutely, I love you. That's okay if you're late, Danny, we're still here.
Danny, who's Danny?
A new guy, Danny Swahili. Said he's late. I haven't seen that name before. I do know someone named Danny. But I'm thinking that's probably not him. Oh. Anal seepage. That reminds me of those chips that came out with that, what, Olestra or whatever it was in it. That said if you ate too many, you could have anal leakage. I was like, I'm not going to eat anything that is going to cause my ass to leak. I'm sorry. That's, no. Just no.
We'll have to get you set. Next time, dude man, just buy some of those little puppy pads.
Here, make sure you sit on this. That's why, I think that's why all the grandmas have plastic couches. You just cover your couch in plastic. Oklahoma law, anyone arrested for soliciting a hooker must have their name and picture shown on television. Yes, they were called Wow Chips.
Yeah, because when you leak, you went, wow. Wasn't expecting that one.
You're an asshole. Oh, I hate you. Welcome, Danny, to two shows about boobs and asses. Oh, my God.
We're going to just rename it the TNA show, but for a whole different reason.
TNA, yeah, but not like you think. Oh. Yes, you guys got the snort.
We got the snort!
Another Oklahoma law, oral sex is a misdemeanor, is punishable by 1 year in jail and $2,500 fine. So how much are you up to now, kitten?
Can we just, like, make a donation to the courts and just have a running tab, just in case?
We've got a tab for when all of our Oklahoma vapor friends get picked up.
Our derpy.
For Derp's wife, and for Eamon's wife, and kitten. There's a great name for the next Vapeon.tv show, Anal Leakage. Oh, I don't know, man. Hey, I'm not the one picking on your state. The one who lives in your state is putting up these weird laws, and I'm just reading them. I don't live there. I live in Illinois. I'm sure there are crazy names, laws here, but... Oh. Yeah, crazy fuckers, indeed. Right, I need another drink, so...
I'd be right afraid to find out what crazy laws New Mexico had.
We'll put our wrestling picture up. I'll be right back, guys. Vape on that thing you put in your underwear to combat. Oh my God, you guys are horrible. Oh, don't share your hamburgers in Oklahoma because they won't tolerate that shit. If I ever go to Oklahoma, I'm going to walk up to a stranger and take a bite out of their hamburger just to break that law. I'll be right back.
Don't be in jail, fuck it.
Thank you.
Oh, it was quiet, that's why. Hi, I'm back. Okay, West Virginia, if any person... Oh, now I gotta scroll up a little bit. Oh, yumminess. West Virginia, if any person arrived at the age of discretion, profanely curse or swear or get drunk in public, he shall be fined by a justice $1 for each offense. Profane swearing and drunkenness penalty. Is it legal to taunt someone for not accepting a challenge for a duel? There's too many words.
Thank you, Chaos. I will make sure that I put curtains on my car, and the second one I have no problem with.
Forbidden for a female to appear unshaven. Make sure you shave your face before you go in public.
Bushy bush! That's it, bushy bush.
Hello, Bushmaster Rar. New York dumb law. The penalty for jumping off a building is death. All lollipops are forbidden. Having sex with a virgin is illegal under any circumstances. How does she become not a virgin then? Goldfish can ride the city bus and bowls only if they are kept still. Do not carry a concealed weapon if it is longer than 6 feet. Illegal to ride upon the streets on an ugly horse. Okay.
Ugly horses need love too.
During Mardi Gras, you may not throw condoms off the floats. Oh, that's too bad, because during Mardi Gras, condoms are probably necessary.
Yeah. I love this song.
Me too. I'm digging the random playlist tonight. I'm not even looking at it. I don't know what's coming up next. Nothing. It just happens.
That song always reminds me of The Lost Boys.
Yeah. Do not let your horse fall asleep at the airport. Okay. Timo! That's a good one. A person may not walk around on Sundays with an ice cream cone in his or her pocket.
He was waiting for somebody to lick it.
You have lost it today, girl.
Oh, no.
I think you just took over Yardbirds with that pun right there.
Dude, Yardbird is the king of puns.
Well, I'm not going to Norfolk because I'm not wearing a corset. I don't want to be all squished like that. I like breathing. I'm just saying.
I will not be able to see.
My theater teacher from high school did theater in college, which makes sense. She did a show where she had to wear a corset, and they tied it too tight, and she said it's too tight. Well, it was like time to go on, so there was no time to loosen it. While she was on stage, she did sneeze. She cracked 3 of her ribs because her corset was too tight.
Was she
wasn't that chesty, so you know she was pushing stomach, skin, and everything up to try to make cleavage at that point.
Oh, Amy, the
pope. Utah birds have the right of way on all highways. A husband is responsible for every criminal act committed by his wife while she is in his presence. Oh my god, that would be the greatest way to get back to your husband if he was a jerk, wouldn't it? Adultery, oral and anal sex, masturbation are considered sodomy and can lead to imprisonment. Oh, I'd be in prison in Utah then, I'm just saying. Sex with an animal unless performed for profit is not sodomy. So if you fuck an animal but the animal doesn't pay you, then you're fine. Wow, this has been a bad, dirty show.
Oh, I'm so jealous of Bush. He went camping. He had pictures.
I hate camping.
Coolest thing. Oh, you like camping. You just haven't been camping with the right people, the right places, the right things.
That's good, Bird. I like that. I don't camp, but I'm glad you got everything packed up, and I'm glad you're back and safe.
Yeah,
Oh my, Pam. Hour notice. By the way, tomorrow at 3 p.m., I'm going to come rob all your shit. Well, illegal to raise alligators in your house. That's illegal pretty much everywhere. I don't know why my groove shark is screwing up. Good night, Laura.
Good night, Laura.
Feel better, darling. I will talk to you soon.
Oh, I love this song.
Me too. I'm sorry. It's a sleepy kind of song, but too bad because I like this one a lot.
Oh, I love Blue October.
Me too. He's kind of hot, even with all the eye makeup that he does.
And the baldness. And ooh.
Oh, I went to college in Normal, Illinois, and I may have made faces at dogs. Thank God I didn't get arrested. Ooh, elk. Can I have some elk meat? I mean, serious.
Carne seca. Bush promised me carne seca.
Ooh. Nummy. But yeah, I went to school in Normal, Illinois, which is funny because I was in Normal, Illinois. Let's talk about that for a half a second there. But no, my husband's friend had, they had a dog in their apartment, and I know I made faces at that dog. Rooms with twin beds only and 2 feet within the beds. And you may not make love between the beds, but on either of them would be perfectly acceptable. Or pushing them together would be okay. Oh, I was totally a criminal. As far as my criminal record is concerned, there's no record anymore, but it has been expunged. I actually got arrested for shoplifting when I was in college. Guess what I was stealing? Hey, vapors, guess what I was stealing? I was stealing cigarettes. And I got busted. Theft under $300. I could have gotten a whole year in jail for that.
I wouldn't know about a flat stomach. I haven't seen one of those in years.
I don't know if I ever had one, even when I was skinny. It was never really...
I always had a poop.
Never really an exactly flat stomach, but... don't care. This is who I am. And you know, without this extra weight, I wouldn't have the girls, because when I was skinny, I had tiny boobs. Timo, no, not if you pushed them to an area that was not between the two beds. One-armed piano players must perform for free. Now this has become silly, silly laws with Spank and Amy. All right, let's do our last giveaway. Let's do our Cafe E-Cig giveaway. Cafe E-Cig is 3 10 milliliter bottles, winner's choice of flavor, PGVG and Nick level. They have some very good things there. We have 28 in the room. Let's go to the giveaway screen. And you guys can see what Cafe E-Cig's little shop looks like. That's the front of their actual shop.
Oh, man. In Eureka, it's illegal for men who wear mustaches to kiss women. That would make me really, really sad because I like hair on faces.
I'm a fan of men's facial hair, yes.
I like the, oh, I love the, like, the little goatee thing.
Oh, yeah, yeah. My husband has a goatee right now.
That is my favorite.
Just saying.
I think a man with a goatee is sexier than all fuck.
Thank you, Billy.
Thank you, Billy.
Go. Don't worry, I don't have very many sleepy songs on my playlist, so I hope no one's dozing off, but I really love this song. In Nevada, you can't have sex without a condom? Well, I'm also a lawbreaker in Nevada, I'm just saying. Oh, Misty, so you made him tired, eh?
We can't go to Florida without having dirty sex with real. It's against the law.
Oh. Well, hopefully I won't get arrested there either. I went to Nevada with my husband. He's fixed. I don't need condoms anymore. So if you wear socks, you're good. And by the light, I'll hold you tonight. I've danced on a number of tables, but I've never weighed my clothing beforehand. Did you ever find out, by the way, that person who you friended on Facebook who said our show was his favorite?
All right,
Kitten, stop for a few minutes because I'm going to have to scroll for days to read these numbers, so just hold on. I want to see more, but just for now. This is his wife on Sunday.
Yes, Emmer, I know.
Uh-oh, Mrs. TK wants to talk to you, Timo. Get your numbers in, Cafe Esig. 3 10 milliliter bottles, Windler's choice of flavor, Nick Level, and Peachy Peachy. And their juice is delicious. If you like vanillas, get their vanilla custard. It is good. Someday I will try Grant's, and then I will tell you guys how it compares, because I know the vanilla snobs always ask, well, how does it compare to Grant's vanilla? I don't know. I have never tried Grant's vanilla.
Timo is kind of nasty.
Yeah, a little bit. Just saying.
I think all our guys that come in here are sexy.
They are. We have some hot hosts. All the ladies that come in here are pretty good looking, too.
Ooh, the girls are hot.
Get your numbers. I'm going to put in the stop. And I know it takes a minute before you actually hear me, so I'm going to wait until I hit enter. In Rochester, Michigan, anyone bathing in public must have his or her bathing suit inspected by a police officer. Where is Zeb when you need a police officer to inspect your bathing suit? I have a PMer who says that Cafe E6 vanilla custard is better than Grant's. Taste is subjective, but that's one vote. Cafe E6. Alright, put in a stop. Hope your number's in. If it wasn't, well, too bad, so sad for you. 15. Alright, help me because there's a lot of typing. 3, 7. I see a 14. Oh, Yardbird with a 15. There are no other 15s that I see. Looks like it's Yardbird. Bird, congratulations.
Yay, Bird.
Scroll down in the list. I'm going to send you my email address. Please send me in the subject line, put Cafe Esig or Cafe Esig winner or something so I know what you won. In the body of the email, send me your name, your address, 3 flavor choices, your PGVG ratio, and your Nick Level. I highly recommend their vanilla custard. Their blue raspberry is pretty tasty. If you like sweet, it is very sweet. And their grape crush is good. If you like menthol, have them add menthol. You can add menthol to any of their fruits. So if you like menthol and you want menthol added, make sure you put that in there because you can add it to any of their fruity ones, not to their vanilla, but their fruity ones, they'll add menthol. Congratulations!
Congratulations, Jack!
And there is my email to you. Oh, I don't want to listen to Heard It Through the Grapevine right now. It's a cool song, but we're going to skip that.
Dancing Raisins.
It's a good song. But, alright, going back on cam. Wow. Christmas was outlawed. Do not put tomatoes in... Well, you don't put tomatoes in clam chowder. I agree with that one. Do not deliver diapers on Sunday regardless of emergencies. Dogs required to have their hind legs tied during the month of April. Okay. Don't hang your feet out a window. Peanuts may not be eaten in court. Mourners at awake may not eat more than 3 sandwiches. Snoring is illegal unless all bedroom windows are closed and securely locked. Well, we'd be in trouble. Goatees are illegal unless you pay a special license fee. I would pay that fee.
I will pay the fee for whoever.
Yeah. Taxi drivers may not make love in the front seat. Well, climb. Climb in the back seat, though. Boston. Illegal to take a bath unless one has been ordered by a physician. Well, you know what? That's fine with me. I hate baths. Who's coming in? You haven't had any visitors tonight.
They have. They've actually come in and poked their head in and then left.
Nobody's been on cam with you tonight. Barbers are not allowed to carry combs on the back of their ears. Okay. Do not water your lawn while it's raining.
And it's pork? Well, I say that is...
Hi, Tanya. Real wants to know why you're coming to Florida.
After I go to Chicago.
Yep, Chicago first. Sorry, I win. Yeah, who elected the Grinch in Massachusetts? No shit, right? Good night, Eric. Thank you for coming by, darling.
Night, Eric.
Yeah, the Mass Holes. They got that name for a good reason. Mass Holes. In Maryland, it is illegal to mistreat oysters. They need to be more descriptive by that. What is mistreatment of an oyster?
Ew.
That's gross. It is illegal to kiss for more than 1 second.
Well, that's just shit.
Okay. Very clean.
Yeah, don't mistreat it.
No mistreating of clams. Oh my god.
Or through and...
My cat is sitting here meowing at me. He needs to just stop. Here he is.
We need to talk, Gammer.
If you use false teeth, then it's aggravated assault. Kitten, you're cracking me up with these laws. You're having a good time, too. Oh my god, my cat is climbing on me.
So what if you have false teeth that you take them out before you bite them?
That would be gumming them and not biting them. Well, fuck Baltimore. My pet lion really wanted to go to the movies there. In Ames, Iowa, a husband may not take more than 3 gulps of beer while lying in bed with his wife or while holding hands. Well, let go or stand up then, dude. Cannot grow old in Salem's lot. I know all the words to this one, too.
To wink at any person is unacquainted. No flirting.
No flirting. No winkies.
Numbers.
Citizens are not allowed to attend a movie house or theater, nor ride in a public streetcar within at least 4 hours after eating garlic. Well, my whole in-law family would never do any of that then, because they're Italian and they hate garlic and like fucking everything. Oh, real, I'm not even going to read that out loud. Oh, Illinois, woohoo! Oh, master instead of mister, not happening. Against the law to speak English in Illinois. Oh, breaking the law right now. Prohibited to drive a car without speaking English. Chicago, eating in a place that is on fire is forbidden.
I will finish this fucking burger now.
I'm going to eat this damn burger before I leave. I don't care that the building's on fire. Oh, God. Roosters must be at least 300 feet away from any residence. It's the Humpty Dance.
Ooh. It is a crime to make love while fishing or hunting on your wedding day. Bushy Bush.
In Urbana, no monster may enter the corporate limits. That's Urbana is Champaign Urbana is like a twin city kind of thing in Illinois, and that's where University of Illinois is. So I could see something like that maybe happening. The monsters in Champaign Urbana.
It is illegal to give lighted cigars to dogs, cats, and other domesticated animals kept as pets. Well, what if you give them anything?
PMer, yes, you are.
Yes, food clams are better, bitch.
Fat girl. Come here, are you ticklish? Yeah, I called you fat. Look at me, I'm skinny. And he was, so that was not a lie. He was a skinny dude.
Yeah,
he was a little bit of a scrawny guy.
You can't fish while sitting on a giraffe's neck?
Well, it's a good thing we don't have a crap ton of giraffes in Chicago, then. In Idaho, it is illegal for a man to give his sweetheart a box of candy weighing less than 50 pounds. So you have to give her 50 pounds of candy or it's illegal. Forbidden for anyone over the age of 88 to ride a motorcycle. That's probably a good thing. You can't sleep in a dog kennel.
Oh, God. This show really wasn't
bad. Oh, Misty, I always have at least one. Some nights I have more. Depends on who shows up to the show. This song cracks me up. I was playing my playlist the other day while I was cleaning, though, and I had to skip this song because my son is 13 and he gets a lot of the jokes in it. I'm like, eh, skip. You have to take a loaded rifle to church in Georgia, or it's a misdemeanor because you went to church. And in Jonesboro, you can't say, oh boy. Well, then you can just say, oh my. Have you guys seen the George Takei reading Fifty Shades of Grey thing? It's funny.
Oh, that is so funny.
And then he gets to the part where he finds out it's a woman, and he goes, oh my. Illegal to sing while wearing a bathing suit. I'd be in trouble. I sing all the time.
You're not allowed to break more than 3 dishes a day or chip the edge off more than 4 cups and or saucers.
Some days that would be a problem for me with my shaky hands. Some days my hands are bad and I drop shit. But that's why I have grown-up sippy cups with a lid. If I drop these, they don't spill and they don't break.
An elephant tied to a parking meter must pay a regular parking fee. Okay, I'm not going to Washington.
Yeah, me neither. That's just when you first wake up. Oh, following George Takei's Facebook page is one of the greatest things I have ever done. His, I don't know if it's really him. I'm not going to say it's not because I don't know. Because, I mean, frankly, what's George Takei doing right now? But my guess is he's got someone who's finding all of those funny things. You're welcome, bird. Congratulations. I mean, I don't know how much he's doing, so maybe he is posting those. Maybe he has someone who posts them for him. But his Facebook page is absolutely rip-roaring hysterical.
Yeah, it is insane.
Everything he posts makes me laugh. You know what? I think George Takei is better than Gilbert Godfrey. Gilbert Godfrey, very funny. I still think George Takei was funnier.
I didn't see Gilbert Godfrey's reading. I'm going to have to check it out.
Yeah, you need to Google that.
Okay, real. Why are they falling asleep?
Yeah, really? If they're falling asleep, I think that's your fault, isn't it? I'm just saying. Yes, if you start out asleep, that's different.
Breakfast of champions.
Just wanted a little protein for breakfast today.
Yeah, start out the day right. They always tell you don't. Breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
Yep. Unlawful to allow a pet cat to run loose without a tail light? Really? I have to tie a light to my cat's tail? Seriously? One of my cats doesn't even hardly like us to pet her. I'm not reading all of that. It's too late.
It's illegal to drop a bird's nest from a public cemetery. Wow.
Illegal to drive more than 2,000 sheep down Hollywood Boulevard simultaneously? Yeah, I'm reading it. I said I wasn't going to, but... Cannot bathe two babies in the same tub at the same time. Well, I would have broken that one. Well, I guess my children are not technically babies at the same time. Jimmy was a toddler when Emma was born. Arkansas. There you go. Arrest me. Yikes, Timo. This is bad. Nothing is better than it. See? And there we go. It was right at the very beginning of the show, and now it's very late in the show. We have discussed it. Sort of. Twice. Anal bleaching.
And seepage.
Yes, and the seepage. That was delightful.
I don't know about delightful. I don't think anything.
Well, the conversation was delightful.
Anal seepage and delightful in the same sentence, baby, does not happen.
The conversation was delightful.
Yes, please take a shit before you do it.
And by the way, that says bowls, not bowels, but...
It doesn't matter, still taking a shit.
Hey, you know, English teacher, I see that. I see things I have to say every once in a while. Fake DM, that just means that she is that talented. I'm not sure, bird. And Timo, if you were really going that fast on a bicycle, that's terrifying.
That's scary.
In Alaska, it is forbidden to push a moose out of a plane in motion. Who has a fucking moose in a plane? I don't care if you live in Alaska. Who takes a moose on a plane? And you can't look at a moose from an airplane either, so don't look out the damn window, because there are mooses.
Mooses?
Yes.
Mooses.
It's moose, I know, but still. Oh. It is illegal for a driver to be blindfolded while operating. Well, that would be a good thing. Can't use a motorboat on city streets. Okay.
How about if you motorboat somebody on the city streets? Does that count?
Right, like, you know. This kind of motorboat, that's totally different. Boobies, look. Vapeon.tv shirt. With the boobies.
I won't do that. I did that to Amy earlier. And she...
And that was delightful. Yes, sad thing is, someone did it if the law is in place. Can't play golf on the street. Can't go outside wearing a mismatched jacket and pants. Can't eat peanuts and walk backwards on the sidewalk during a concert. That's a very specific law. Cannot turn around and look at a woman in that way. In what way?
You have to wear horse blinders.
Who determines what all in the that way? Like, every dude in the place should be wearing blinders then. I'm sorry. Every single one. A dead person cannot be required to serve on a jury. Cannot fish with canned corn. Things are funny. Thanks, I didn't have to do anything other than read your stuff tonight, kid. This is awesome. Fine, arrested or jailed for making faces at a dog. Again, this whole making faces at a dog thing. Oh, in Oklahoma, make sure that you don't whale hunt. Because there are so many whales in the middle of the fucking country where there's no water.
In Clinton, it's masturbating while watching two people having sex in the car is forbidden.
Well, then be specific when you choose your movies online, people.
That.
Oh, I love crazy laws. There's one that I heard, and it's not nearly as funny as these, but there's a town near me called Joliet, Illinois. It's J-O-L-I-E-T. A lot of people call it Joliet, which would be the inappropriate pronunciation. If you pronounce the name of the city incorrectly in earshot of a city council member, they can fine you $50. They can fine you $50. I was like, really? So if I say Joliet and one of the fucking council members hear me, then I have to pay $50 fine for mispronouncing the name of the city. I was like, that's just weird.
Can't have sex with a truck driver inside a toll booth.
All right, I'm going to go and make myself a drink. I know you're probably going to go at the end of the show, but I'm not. So I'll be right back. And they can't see you, so if you need to adjust, go for it, Sissa. You can't sell a toothpaste and toothbrush to the same customer on a Sunday. But what if they need to brush their teeth? Come on now. Come back. Operating a motor vehicle while sitting in another person's lap is forbidden. How will I teach my children how to drive? They're too short. A police person may bite a dog to quiet him. Poor doggy.
Tainted pickles? tainted.
I love this song. All right, so this song gives me a memory. At one point, probably in the 1980s, Tony Danza tap danced to this song on Johnny Carson. And I can't find the video of it at all. A parent can be arrested if their kid burps in church. Awesome.
In it.
Wow.
Oh.
You have to wear the nightshirts given to you by the hotel to have sex. In Nebraska, in Hastings, Nebraska. If you know something, if some of these make me want to like go to these places and say, "Hey, listen, you need to give me and my husband these nightshirts because we're totally gonna screw in your hotel."
And you will be liable for accessory to a crime.
Exactly. If you don't give me these nightshirts, then I'm gonna tell them it's your fault that I had sex in your hotel because you wouldn't provide these nightshirts.
Okay, you can't drink beer in a bucket.
Well, that's probably not a bad thing. It's on like Donkey Kong. Try anything once. Well, you know, there are a lot of try anything once kind of people in the world, just saying. Garlic, onions, or sardines. Again, my husband would be in trouble. No child under the age of 12 may talk over the telephone unless accompanied by a parent. I don't want to sit on the phone while my almost 11-year-old daughter talks on the phone. Oh my god.
Oh, I love Duck Dynasty. Five my favorite.
Did you see the pictures of the Duck Dynasty guys without their beards?
No.
Holy mother of god, they are hot. I'm not kidding. Wow. Somebody posted it on Facebook. I will have to find it, but oh my god. Like, model hot.
Well, I know that they have, like, awesome dimples.
Well, yeah, but two of them have dimples, but oh my god. I saw these pictures, like, this is total. They can't be the same person. Yeah, I don't want to hear about her nails and her clothes. I don't watch Duck Dynasty, but somebody posted the pictures. I'll have to find it and tag you in it, Spanky, because I remember who posted it. I'll dig around, and I will send it to you.
Okay.
Because, I mean, I was amazed. I mean, I knew they would look different. But they looked so... You would never... If they put pictures up next to each other, you would never think that it was the same person, ever. Because, I mean, I've seen it a little bit here and there, and I'm like, wow, that really good-looking woman is married to that guy? Okay, well, you know, to each their own. They don't look all that good to me, but, you know, for everybody there is somebody and all that kind of stuff. And then I saw the pictures of them, like, in their wedding pictures and stuff before they grew the beards, and I was like, oh, I totally get it now, because these dudes are hot. And I wonder how many of their wives who are like, shave that shit off.
But they were, like, saying no, that they really liked the beards.
Well, you know. They are scratchy in all the right places.
Ooh, I love peanut butter balls, Steve's.
Oh,
those are like my favorites to make. They're better than Reese's.
My cat is trying to climb on my chair. Get down. I hate to see any duck die nasty. By the way, Spanky, the show is officially over. I know that you have your own time at V Liquid on Friday nights. I'm not trying to get rid of you. If you want to stay, that's awesome. But I know this is Spanky time to get out and, you know, not be mom. So whenever you need to go, darling, just let me know.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, you taking off? All right, honey, I will talk to you soon, I'm sure, because we talk all the time.
Yeah.
Thanks, good show. Awesome laughing. Guys. And I snorted, so everybody wins. Good night, Spanky. Hanging up on you now. Bye. And now you guys are just stuck with me. And no more giveaways. Just me. I don't know how long I'm here. Not a clue. Oh, I hope Spanky's still reading. Spanky, if you're still reading or listening, ask about chocolate covered pretzel. I'll write that down, Misty. Because I have to send her stuff anyway. See, we have our own conversation outside of the show. There's a whole conversation behind the show. So how's everybody? I could put up the fill-in show. Let's do that. There we go. I have to move the fill your boobies down here. I'm not filling into anything, but beer is good for you. Timo, that's awesome. And we will discuss the posting of that later. Remind me, because I'll forget. Good night, Beebs. Enjoy making balls. Thanks for coming by. I don't know how long I'm here. Yes, you totally made me snort, and I held back on the snorting for a little while. I really did. I fought it. Oh my god, PMer. Wow. Wow, that's not funny, and that's really bad. Good night. Happy birthday. A day late. Enjoy that car. Someday I'm going to get a ride in that car. Just saying. I'm not saying I'm going to drive it. Cool. Thanks, Timo. Good night, Mrs. TK. Thanks for coming by. There are a bunch of names in here that, like, didn't talk. That makes me sad. Well, PMer, exactly. Why would you? I hope you get that worked out, honey. I really do. Oh, real? Don't talk about his car? I've seen pictures of his car, and it just makes me really sad because it's not my car. That was pretty early in the show, Timo. That was about 25, maybe 30 minutes in. Well, I would text my husband and find out when he was going to be home, but I walked through the bedroom earlier and his phone is on our bed. So I'm not quite sure when he's going to be home. But I will probably be here until 30 after the hour, and then I'm going to go, whether he's back or not, because I have some conversations to have with other people on Skype and some stuff to handle. He has a Chevelle, and his Chevelle is red, and I want a red Chevelle so bad. It's beautiful, and I don't remember what year it is. It's beautiful. PMer, exactly. You would notice, right? Well, fight that. Yes, real. He is on Facebook. You can find him. And I think that he is... I think you can find him with his screen name, but I'm not sure. And I don't want to put his real name out there because he's not here. So. Good night, darling. I love you, too. Thank you. Yeah, I got nothing extra to give away. If you need to go to bed, now's the time. Unless you want to hang out. Yes, PMer, absolutely. Fight that as well. That's really shitty, and keep me updated on that one, because that's really bad. I think you're right, Billy. I think it is a 1970. A 68 is my favorite, but I wouldn't complain if I had a 70. Just saying. They're not that much different. There are minor differences between a 68 and a 70. So minor that I would never complain. If you heard that, I'm sorry. I tried to make that a quiet burp. It was a little bit louder than I intended. It is a design. Let me see if I can... It's hard for me to... Hold on. Not officially a fill-in show, but it's also not our show. Strawberry Field, I got this at a cart in Old Vegas. Danny Swahili, I'm still here. It's not officially Spank and Amy anymore, but I'm still here. And Billy, if you just told me to shush, you're number one, honey. I can't shush. I'm here by myself. With filibuster. No, it's not filibuster either. No, I put this up because the other night we didn't, Tuesday? Nobody was broadcasting. Yes, this is after hours shit, but I don't have an after hours splash screen, so... All I have is the super awesome fill-in show with Amy Wamey background. I'll make an after-hours splash screen for next week. I'm sorry. I have a text message I have to answer. But yeah, nobody was on, and I felt bad, so I was like, okay. I didn't have anything to give away. We just hung out. We visited. It was relaxing and delightful. And I like this background, even though it says, you know, fill it awesome, super awesome fill-in show. The background is kind of cool. It's like all different colored lightning and shit. It's kind of good. Bootsy Collins right there at the end of that show. Y'all are crazy. Oh, and then Justin Timberlake. He's a weird, nerdy, you know, permy-headed, bleach blonde boy who has turned into a really hot dude. Gay Pride Lightning, it's not quite rainbow. But I'm all for gay pride. I don't think who you love and who you have sex with is any of my damn business. It's not my business. I feel that way about a lot of things. Religion, sexuality. If it's not hurting me and you're not pushing me to be who you are. Yes, legal consenting age does make a difference. Now, if you want to sleep with 13-year-old girls, well, then I have an issue with that. But if you're a boy and you love boys, or you're a girl and you love girls, who you love is none of my fucking business. At all. None. If you're a good person and you're a good community member and you're not, you know, stabbing other people because they're not gay, fine. Good for you. High five. You're getting yours and you're happy. Some of the best relationships that I know actually are gay people. The most secure relationships, and they've not fallen apart, all that kind of stuff. No, exactly, or what you put in or do with your body. Not my business. Totally not. And people say, oh, well, I don't want to see two dudes making out in the mall. You know what? I don't want to see a dude and a chick making out in the mall. If you want to make out, go get in your car, go home. Something. Don't do that shit in public. I'm not against holding hands, arm around each other, or a little, you know, kind of peck in public. But I don't want to see any couple making out in public. Full on making out in public. I don't care if it's two girls, two guys, or a guy and a girl. I don't need to see that. That's private and personal. You don't do that shit in front of everybody. Exactly. Get a room. Or car. Something. I don't need to see that shit. My best friend lives in South Dakota. And apparently in South Dakota, two women walking through the mall holding hands would be cause for a lot of people to turn around and look. She was here and we went to the mall. And she said, ooh, let's hold hands. That would be funny. And I didn't tell her that in the Chicago suburbs, it's really not a big deal. I mean, I'm 30 minutes from downtown Chicago, so we're semi-big city at the mall we were at. And we're walking through the mall holding hands, and she's like, wow, not one single person in this mall even looked at us twice. I said, because nobody here cares. She said, if we did this at my mall, she said, every person would walk past us and be horrified. I said, that's terrible. Yeah, ring. I agree. All the people who saw that shit when I was in high school, too. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I made out in front of you when I was in high school. You feeling me? Let's do something. High schoolers do that, though, but, you know, it is what it is. Everybody needs to chill out. That's the biggest thing about all of this. Everybody just needs to chill the fuck out. Everybody is so uptight. Ring, I am 41. I will never lie about my age. I am 41 years old. And I didn't even know that two of my very best friends were gay. In retrospect, my gaydar should have picked that up, but they were not out to anyone. They weren't out to their best friends. They weren't out to their families. Nobody. They hid it from everyone. I'm glad it changed. You know who you like. Yeah, you couldn't be out. You couldn't. And that sucks, but it's good that it's different. It is. Because all of the gay people and the lesbian people that I know said that they have known for a very long time that they were who they were. So, I'm glad it's becoming better. I look at it like interracial relationships. For so long, those were so negative. And everything was so bad about those. And now, in most parts of the country, nobody bats an eye when they see an interracial couple holding hands or, you know, kissing or whatever. It's going to become that, and that's good. But I don't want to be all political. It's 12:19 a.m. and I'm drunk. Drunkish. Oh, good night, Billy. Thanks for coming and putting links in the show for us. I appreciate the link ninja stuff. Oh, Danny Swahili, I'm glad you love this place. Come here every Friday. Sometimes we won't go past 12 o'clock. Most Fridays, I'm here for a while after 12. And I want to say, I love this song. Exactly, Ring. I didn't choose who I am. So how can you say that someone else chose who they are? And why would someone choose a lifestyle that has been for a very, very, very long time so badmouthed and so persecuted? Why would you ever choose anything that was going to make people hate you? I mean, if it's a choice, why would you ever go, you know what? I want to be gay so everyone hates me. No one chooses that shit. Really? That was the one right next to it. I'm going to skip this song. I'm not in a disturbed mood right now. Let's see what comes up. No, not that either. Nope, not that either. Nope. Oh, wait. Yes. All right. Sending a text message. Sorry. I'm popular. I'm just kidding. Not you. You're not drinking. I'm sorry you're not drinking. Or maybe good that you're not. I don't know anything about the Magneto. I don't know where you can get it. I don't know where the best place to get it is. Nothing. Mechanical mod scary. Thank you. ring. I'm glad to hear that. Good night, bird. Thanks for coming to the show, honey. Strawberry, yes. Some of my very best friends are gay. Because they are really wonderful people. Not because they're gay, but because they are understanding and compassionate, like you said, and they're very nice. Misty, no. I'm sure you said, but I don't know. And if it was black menthol, then you need to just not vape it at all and send it all to my house. But I don't have any more. This is all I have left in my black menthol. Timo, you saw nothing. I was not given permission to use that picture. That's why it was flashed on the screen quickly. So, you saw nothing. No, ring, no. Exactly. The shop vac was dirty. And no, Missy, I don't need any. I'm good. I put in an order today. I'm good. Ring, it was a dirty corner of the shop that Matt didn't want me to put up because it looked all construction-y and dirty, and he wanted me to put up the picture of Bee Liquid with the perfect clean, the lab where it was perfectly clean and stuff. I had a picture of his lab that was all dusty and dirty and crappy looking. And I said, oh, I'm going to put this up and say it's ghetto bee liquid. Well, this is going to be my last song. And then I'm going to go. Good luck, Big T. Oh, I know you would, Misty. If I was desperate, I would find a way to get it. But no, I ordered it. It's all good. It's coming. Strawberry Field. Exactly. I want my children to be respected and treated properly. And if that means my daughter has a woman who is respecting her and treating her properly, so be it. Or for my son with a man. I just want my kids to be treated right. I really don't care who they're treated right by, so long as they're treated right. But there are parents who don't feel that way, and that's horrible. To say that you would disown your child if they were gay, that's terrible. It's really, really, really awful. Your child is always your child. I'm skipping songs till I find one I want to hear. Alright, Cruel Summer, and then we're done. Well, Ring, I'm glad that you never miss our show. We do have one viewer that friended me on Facebook. And did not friend Spanky. Spanky friended that person recently, who told another host that our show was their favorite, and I feel really, really, really bad, but I don't know who that person is because they don't have their screen name on their Facebook. Timo, exactly. Well, I can't be a grandmother at 32 because I'm 41, but still. Ring, I'm really sorry to hear that. Misty? See? So, his orientation doesn't make a rat's ass bit of difference. But yeah, Timo, exactly. Don't make me a grandmother really young. My son is 13. I'm 41 now. Don't make babies young. Other than that, I don't care. And people say, oh, you have a son and a daughter. Aren't you so worried for your daughter? Nope. Absolutely not, because my daughter has a very strong personality. My son, on the other hand, I am worried about all those little bitches who are going to come after my boy. Yes, that's different. Well, and generally speaking, I'm a little bit of an older mom. I had my son at 28 and my daughter at 30. If I had kids at 20 and 22, that would be different. Misty, I'm just going to send mine to a convent. There are two that are local. I figure after she graduates from 8th grade, I'm just going to send her there. Let her do high school with the nuns. Okay, this is really the last song because I like this one, but after this I am going to stop streaming. You guys can still hang out. The chat is open 24/7 for all of your vaping visiting needs. Whether there is a host or not, you can always pop in, visit with other vapers, compare stories, ask questions. Sometimes there are hosts here, sometimes there are not. Thank you so much for all of you coming. Thank you for all of you hanging out. For the little extra. And I will see you all next week. I actually have a see you next week picture. I forgot about it. I was going to put this up when Spanky left. Thanks, everybody. Thank you, sponsors. See you next week. Enjoy. And as always.